How can you heal your childhood trauma? In this video, I'm going to tell you 6 reasons why some people don't heal their childhood trauma and what you need to do so that you can.
Start with healing one trigger at a time. You can do this.
I'm Tamara Ridge, licensed marriage and family therapist who's discovered the secrets to unlocking the body's process for healing childhood trauma. Reason number one why some people don't heal their PTSD is because they don't follow the body. Trauma teaches us not to trust our bodies. So the first step in the healing process is to rebuild that trust. What gets in the way is other people's advice, including therapists and loved ones, and maybe even the people who hurt us in the first place. You need to get comfortable listening to your body and learning to trust your body. Here's why. Triggers form categories in the trauma brain, and it tells us that everything that's even remotely connected to something that happened before is dangerous. But the reality is that sometimes when we're triggered, we're actually safe. Triggers are healing opportunities. That's the foundation of healing childhood trauma. It has to start with you following your body, because you know your body's the one that's telling you where your triggers are. And that's how you focus to start the healing process. The second reason why some people are able to heal their PTSD and some people aren't is that the people who aren't focus on the past. We need to know what happened, but we don't need to tell the story. You're the expert, and your body is giving you all of the information that you need to know to heal your triggers right now. The reason we know we're triggered is because we have something happening in the here and now that doesn't fit the context. You don't even have to think about telling the story until your body is ready to release the emotions that are connected to the trigger after the trigger is healed. The third reason that someone would not heal from trauma is because they're not getting a handle on their stress. Childhood trauma is often called complex post-traumatic stress disorder. Think about that. It's a stress disorder. And when we have childhood trauma, handling stress is quite difficult. But we have to get a handle on our stress because there's no way to calm down the trauma brain and listen to the body history and heal triggers when they come up if the brain is in fight or flight. It's a well-known fact that when our brain is in fight or flight, we don't have access to our IQ. And you need your IQ to target the trigger so that you can eliminate them. So you have to calm your body and your nervous system. Reason number four that some people do not heal their PTSD is that they're not focusing on actually healing the triggers. This is really a pet peeve of mine. If you've noticed in this video, I've talked about
triggers.
Well, I've had childhood trauma. My earliest memory of trauma was at 2. And it kept going throughout my life. I'm not gonna tell you the story because there's too many professionals telling their trauma stories. It's a bad example to give. We don't have to tell the trauma story to heal. It's enough for me to tell you that. Trauma didn't leave my life until about 2 years ago. The process I'm telling you about is the process that I've used to heal myself. When I've shared this process with my clients, we focus on triggers and people heal. Reason number 5 is because they don't separate the triggers from their feelings about them. One of the problems with talk therapy is that triggers get lost and all bundled up in these drawn out stories that you tell. Healing comes in 2 parts. You heal the trigger, then you deal with your feelings that you're having about the trigger. The trigger's released and there's no more need to hold that emotion in the body, so the body lets it go. Now I have a question for you. Which one of these reasons that people don't heal do you need to improve on based on what you've learned in this video? I'd love to hear that. Drop it down in the comments. And if you're getting value in today's video, hit the subscribe button so that you can keep up with tips and strategies for healing your childhood trauma. Reason number 6 why some people are not able to heal their PTSD, they're trying to address developmental gaps without healing the triggers first. So let me give you an example. Childhood trauma survivors often have difficulty receiving comfort in relationship. That's because our original childhood injuries usually happened in close relationship. So in our trauma brain, close relationship is paired with harm, which is the opposite of receiving comfort. Those same survivors then grow up and often beat themselves up because they're afraid to get close to others. They're afraid to be open and vulnerable in their adult relationships. I'm gonna tell you what to do in this situation. First, you follow your body to the source of the trigger. In this case, why am I so afraid when my partner wants to give me a hug? Second, you identify the real context of the past while you stay focused on the here and now. That's a question like this. When my partner wants to give me a hug and I feel myself tense up, what does this remind me of? Then third, you help your body shift into the present using strategies for healing triggers that change the potential danger of a hug to safe inside the trauma brain. And then step number four is you heal the freaking trigger. You teach your brain that you're safe in your partner's hug when you know that you really are, even though your trauma brain wants to tell you that you're in danger. Step number five, do the grief work. Now it's time to talk about how angry and sad you feel because somebody from your past taught you that hugs were dangerous instead of nurturing. If you have a safe relationship, this is the time to talk about it. This is the time to say, I'm really angry that that person taught me to be afraid when I'm in your arms. Then you'll be free to be in close relationship, to receive those hugs and to have them feel good without your trauma brain going crazy. So those are the six reasons why someone wouldn't heal their childhood trauma and what you need to do instead. I'll see you in the next video.